Good afternoon, Dr. Vikram.
Good afternoon.
Dr. Vikram, there is a very important theory in Ayurveda, theory of three doshas.
Yeah.
So we want your time so that you can explain it.
Yeah, Tridosha theory is very important, the base of Ayurvedic theories. There are three doshas. Three means three, and Vata, Pitta and Kapha.
Yeah.
They are called dosha. Dosha, literally meaning of dosha is abnormality. But it doesn't mean there are abnormalities. There can be balance of doshas.
Okay.
The state of balance of dosha is health in our body, and their imbalance is disease. So they are called dosha because they are also holding the energy. Their energies in our body holding their work like tissues also sometimes. Like dhatus also. They work like dhatus also. That's why they are called, they are not called dosha, abnormal things. That is normality of the body also.
So what are those three doshas?
These are Vata, Pitta and Kapha. Air, fire and earth and water. So basically these are manifestations of three energies
in the universe. Okay. So our body is made up of the natural things. So from nature it comes.
There is an ancient work, Visarga Dan Vikshepe, Som Surya Anla Yatha, Dharyanti Jagdeham, Kaf with Anla Stata. For example, in the whole universe you see, the water is there, the sun is there, the moon is there, which is holding the world. And similarly, Vata, Pitta and Kapha, they are holding the body inside.
So Vata is the air element, like that it is flowing here now.
Our body, our universe is made up of five elements mainly.
Okay.
Earth, water, fire, air and space. These five elements, they are represented as three doshas. Earth and water is Kapha.
Okay.
Fire is Pitta. Mm-hmm. And air and space is Vata.
Okay.
So this is, that makes them three dosha. Vata, Pitta and Kapha. Pitta is fire, mm-hmm. Earth and water is Kapha, and air and space is Vata.
Okay.
So we'll talk about Vata today. What is Vata? Vata is, you can understand as functions of Vata or the place of, first of all, as just imagine air. Air is causing the movement.
Yes, characteristics,
so
you want to say.
Characteristic of Vata is movement. I am moving my hands, I am moving my heart is moving. It is
Whatever is in movement is due to Vata. Okay.
Excretory system, mm-hmm. The nervous system. The functionality of the nervous system,
mm-hmm.
The movement in the body, the blinking of the eyes and the release of excretory substances,
okay.
That is all controlled by Vata.
Mm-hmm.
Urination.
Very interesting.
Yeah, urination and defecation,
mm-hmm.
And peristaltic
movement. Thoughts of our mind are also Vata?
Of course.
Okay.
So yeah, when that is also movement of mind.
Okay.
So for example, this Vata is moving this tree, these leaves.
Yeah.
Similarly, Vata is causing the movement of everything, movement of nutrients in our body. So whenever there is, that is one part, that one aspect.
Movement. Okay.
Because it is called chala or mobile. Mobility is the characteristics of Vata.
So what are the other characteristics?
There are so many that I will tell you.
Okay.
And there is one more important characteristic, that is cooling. Cool. Shita.
Okay.
So it is cooling. It is cool. Air is usually causing cooling of the temperature.
Mm-hmm.
So similarly in our body, Vata is cooling. It has cooling property. And whenever we eat something cool, it increases Vata.
Oh,
that is simple principle. So if we usually when we take something hot or warm, that reduces Vata. Warm food and warm spices, hot spices.
Yeah.
And sweet is also reducing Vata because it is heavy. Third property is lightness. Vata is light. So if you are consuming something opposite to the light property of Vata, like heavy food, sweet food, which has earth and water in it, that reduces the properties of Vata.
Okay.
So to balance the Vata, we need to consume food which
opposite
is having opposite. Not only food, but also lifestyle, our thoughts and our behavior and food. These are the three, four things which we should follow.
What I am able to understand, like meditation is to control the Vata, to control
meditation
the mind.
Meditation is another thing.
Okay.
First, I was talking about the food, the routine, the lifestyle, and meditation is also one part to slow down things, to control the vata. Because vata is life, it is also vitality. You see the air, in the air you see oxygen is there, and it is life-giving.
Yes.
So vata is
life-giving. Very important. Yeah.
It is a very important characteristic of vata. It is also transparent, clear. You can see across.
Yes.
If there is
there is no hindrance.
Yeah, yeah. So vata is transparent. It is light. It is minute. It can go inside the minutest of holes. That is vata. And vata, if there is imbalance of vata in our body, and place of natural place of vata in our body is colon, the large colon.
Okay.
And the bones. That is where the vata lives naturally.
Okay.
And if the, you can understand, a lower part of the body is vata, middle part of the body is pitta, upper part of the body is kapha. So that is easy way to remember. So lower part means the this colon,
yes,
and the big bones.
Mm-hmm.
That is place of vata. And when, how it is, the balance of vata is maintained, and what are the functions of vata? As I told you, the mobility, the thinking, the imagination, the way of thinking, and memory, all
everything
all system related to the nervous system.
Okay.
All the thinking process. And
so, Dr. Vikram, how one should balance the vata?
There is a simple principle, sarvada sarabhavana samanya vriddhi karnam haras hitu visheshast. That means similar things increase similar thing, opposite things decrease the...
Okay, that is a principle, okay.
That is universal law. If there is bowl of water, you add more water, it becomes more water.
Yes.
Similarly, there are five elements are there in the universe. In the food also, there are five elements.
Everywhere.
Everywhere, there are five elements.
Mm-hmm.
And your body is also made up of five elements.
Mm-hmm.
You take element which are high in vata,
mm-hmm.
food items which are high in vata, they will increase the vata.
Okay.
If you eat the food which is low in vata,
mm-hmm.
which is having vata pacifying properties,
okay,
they can reduce the vata. So it is very important to understand the properties of various food items, whether it can increase the vata or whether it can decrease the vata. Similarly, there are herbs which are having properties to reduce the vata and increase the vata. There are vata pacifying and vata
Dr. Vikram, I have a question in mind, like how one can feel that vata is not in balance in his body.
Vata is the main cause of diseases, mainly
if
diseases.
It is not in balance.
Yeah, if it is in imbalance.
Yeah.
If it is, if you are having healthy state of mind, a healthy state of
body
affairs,
okay,
then your vata is in balance state.
Okay.
If you have no pain, you are having regular bowel movements, if there is no gas, flatulence or acidity, and your mind is calm, no stress, anxiety and fears or any phobias, and you are not restless, that is your vata is in balance. If you are having all such symptoms, then that means there is vata imbalance. And the food, there are 3-4 ways you can you get the vata gets imbalanced.
Like?
For example, the food items, late night sleep, long travel, and incompatible foods, fermentation going on in your digestive system, that causes constipation, that leads to vata imbalance. And pitta and kapha, they are not moving in our body, they are moved by vata.
Okay.
So if there is imbalance of vata, there can be possibility that vata can cause imbalance of pitta and kapha also.
So it is a very main...
Then two doshas can be imbalanced, three doshas can be imbalanced. So it is very important to take care of vata.
So what kind of major diseases one can suffer if he is not controlling or balancing vata?
Yes, major diseases, constipation, nervous disorders, stroke, paralysis, blood pressure, and paralysis of one limb or the other limb, or unable to, there is a locomotive disorder like skeletal muscle disorders, painful joints, osteoarthritis,
these are tissue disorders, okay,
and depression, sadness, mania, mental disorders, psychiatric disorders.
These are all caused by imbalance of vata.
Nervous tissue, mainly you can understand nervous tissue disorders, and sometimes numbness of the limbs, numbness in the limbs. It is also nervous system. Oh. Nervous system, skeletal system, and the digestive system. It all starts from there. And vata can cause imbalance of pitta and kapha, that can lead to all kind of diseases.
Other disorders, okay.
It is mentioned that pitta is handicapped. Pitta cannot move. Handicapped, you know, cannot move without the help of somebody. Kapha is handicapped.
Yes.
But vata moves them. So it is like in Ayurveda, there is a verse, pitta pangu, kaf pangu. Pangu is handicapped.
Okay.
Pitta pangu, kaf pangu. Pangu mal dhatva. Mala is toxins. Dhatva means all the tissues. They are all pangu. Vayuna yatra niyante tatra gishanti megvat. Wherever vayu wants, vata wants to take them, they go just like a meg, the
clouds, okay,
full of water is there, but it rains wherever the
air takes it. Them. Yeah, natural principle,
it.
Okay.
Yeah. So it is an analogy given in Ayurveda. So vata, pitta and kapha are pangu, and vata takes them, and vata can move, cause the displacement from their natural places.
So it's a, one of the very important
very
doshas,
doshas,
and one and should regulate or balance it.
So pranayama is also very important. Prana means life. Mm-hmm. Ayama means to control. So when you are breathing, you are connected with the universal vata and with your internal vata through breathing.
Okay.
How the vata is going in your body?
Through breathing. Okay.
So if you know the techniques to learn to control the vata, that is through pranayama and meditation.
Yes.
So it is very important to do regular pranayama.
Meditation.
Regular meditation.
Uh-huh.
And also know the characteristics of different food items. And also know your own prakriti. Some people are vata type.
Okay.
Prakriti, there are certain prakriti or individual natures.
Mm-hmm.
So individual nature, you can go to my website planetayurveda.com and you can just check what is your mental type or what is your body type.
Okay.
According to that, you will be as a vata person, pitta person, kapha person, and vata pitta person.
Yes.
And combination. So you accordingly you eat your food, accordingly you can balance the doshas and prevent the diseases.
Knowing your prakriti is very important.
Prakriti is very very important. Mm-hmm. So best is pranayama, meditation, and knowing your prakriti so that you can know your food, which is good for your type.
Sometimes, Dr. Vikram, I actually saw you in your clinic also. You check with pulse and with the shape of body and characteristics of that person, like he is vata or kapha. So, kindly give us some brief information like one can judge easily whether he is vata or not.
Vata people, usually they are lean and thin. Usually.
Okay.
Their bones are protruding.
Okay.
Their bones are very visible. Their face.
Okay.
And their face is like very sharp features and cuts.
Okay.
And their eyes are not so big. They have smaller eyes. And the skin is dry. The hair are dry. They have twin hairs. They are falling. And the bones, they make noise. And they are too much communicative. Thinking, their thinking is very fast. They are not patient. They don't
impatient. They are impatient.
They are
okay.
Impatient.
Yeah.
Irritable. They, if the vata is imbalanced.
Okay.
They are not able to wait for long.
Yes.
If you see them, if they are in a plane or in a train or in a bus, they are the first one to stand up. When the bus stops, they get up. Get out of it.
Yeah.
Even in the plane also.
Yeah.
So they are very impatient.
The people who are in front of the queue when the plane lands, they are vata type.
They are, But Vata has so many positive qualities. They are very creative. They are very imaginative.
Okay.
They can create things because they have good imagination. They are good artists.
Okay.
They are good philosophers. They are thinkers.
Okay.
And they decide very fast. They are quick. They decide and implement the decisions. But they have so many things in their mind at the same time. So some projects they start, they cannot, usually they cannot complete all the projects.
But they start many. Okay.
At the same time. So
okay.
That is Vata. So that is, if you are able to control your Vata, then you can be successful in so many fields. You are creative, you are full of energy, enthusiasm. What is life? It actually, Vata is the cause of life.
Yes.
It is the beginning of the universe. This Akash, this Akasha Mahabhuta and Vata. Akash Mahabhuta started the universe and Vata took it forward. So this was responsible for the formation of the
how universe. The universe
how
is spreading.
Started.
Okay.
So space is Akasha and Vata is movement.
Okay.
So this is how it is spreading and expanding.
Mm-hmm.
At quantum level, if you see, Vata is very important dosha.
That's wonderful. Dr. Vikram, there was one more inquiry during the talk, like how you check it from pulse, Vata, basically.
Yeah, we check not only Vata.
All the three doshas.
You asked the question previously also, I forgot to answer.
Mm-hmm.
These three doshas we see just at the base of the thumb.
Okay.
There is a pulse we see. This first finger is representing Vata.
Mm-hmm.
And second is Pitta. Third is Kapha.
Okay.
So Vata, Pitta, Kapha, we have with experience you can analyze.
Okay.
If the movement of Vata is like a snake,
mm-hmm,
in the pulse, and the movement of Pitta is like a frog, and the movement of Kapha is like a swan. So this way you can analyze, and there are five types of Vata, five types of Pitta, five types of Kapha. So we have to analyze all those five types.
And that's why people visit you to meet personally to get them checked.
Yeah, it is very important.
For pulse diagnosis.
If you need, pulse is a way of diagnosing the disease.
Okay.
There are so many other methods of diagnosis. So we can diagnose through the pulse. We can diagnose the imbalance through the Prakriti.
Mm-hmm.
We can diagnose the imbalance through just by looking at the person, by the tongue, by the eyes, by the way he speaks, by the urine, by the stool, and by the condition of his skin, and by touching him, and by asking questions.
Okay.
So there are so many methods of diagnosis.
So pulse diagnosis is the accurate one, or
pulse,
it's a one of
pulse
them?
Pulse diagnosis is like a final diagnosis if you are not able to make any diagnosis.
Okay.
And you just diagnose the pulse.
Right.
And then you understand that this is the situation.
Okay.
You can see the Prakriti, you can see the condition of the doshas, you can see the condition of the tissues,
mm-hmm,
or the different organs. So all the things can be analyzed from the pulse.
So, Dr. Vikram, are there any herbs which are good for people like suffering with Vata disorders?
Brahmi is excellent for people having Vata disorders.
Okay.
Brahmi is calms down the nervous system.
Mm-hmm.
Brahmi is there, and Ashwagandha is there. Shatavari is there. We have a product, female health support for females. They have Vata imbalances, irregular hormones. Hormones are also controlled by Vata.
Oh.
Because they are moving in the body and causing the movement. And female health support is there.
Mm-hmm.
And for mind, Ashwagandha is there. Brahmi is there.
So these are herbs which helps.
Which are having, there is a concept, post-digestion effects. In Ayurveda, that is called Vipaka.
Okay.
If we eat some food after the digestion, what effects it is giving? It is building your muscles, building your body, growing your body, or it is helping
suppressing,
suppressing or cutting down your weight.
Okay.
It is anabolic or it is catabolic. Certain ways, certain foods are anabolic, certain are catabolic. So usually Vata foods, they are catabolic. They are reducing the weight.
Okay.
So to reduce the Vata, you should take anabolic foods, heavy, warm food, which is opposite food or herbs.
Okay.
So this Brahmi is excellent for Vata.
Ashwagandha, Brahmi, and Shatavari, these are better. Okay.
Amlaki is also good. Amlaki is good for Tridosha.
Okay.
For all the doshas. Amlaki Rasayan. Rasayan is for rejuvenating.
And Giloy also?
Giloy is excellent for all three doshas.
Okay, okay.
So I'm using Giloy for all problems.
So basically these are the herbs which are for balancing.
Balancing.
Okay, okay. Thank you very much, Dr. Vikram. And I think this will help a lot to the Vata people.
Yes.
Thank you very much.